Hi kids, how are you all? I hope you all must be fine, right? So today we are going to read for class 3 Science Olympiad. And in class 3 Science Olympiad, which portion we are going to read? We are going to discuss the previous year question paper of level 2 SOF NSO. Okay, so in our previous session, we have already discussed some questions. And in our today's session, we are going to discuss some more questions. Okay. So, are you all ready for it? Yes. So, let's get started. Our first question, 6 objects are classified into 2 groups as shown in the table. The objects are grouped according to option A, their flexibility, B, the materials they are made of, C, whether they are waterproof, D, none of these. And in group Y, plastic sheet, envelope and newspaper are there. In group Z, iron nail, case tube and bricks are there. Okay. So here 6 objects are there which are classified into 2 groups. And we have to find the objects are grouped according to this. So here the objects are grouped according to their flexibility. So in group Y, that is the plastic sheet, envelope and newspaper, these are flexible. But in group Z, iron nail, test tube and brick are there which are not flexible. So here the correct option is option A. Got it? Coming to the next question, read the given paragraph. Anisha is making snowman with her friends in her backyard, whereas Kavis is beating the heat by eating ice cream. Identify the places where Anisha and Kavish dwell and the weather they are experiencing and select the correct statement regarding this. Options are A. Anisha might be wearing clothes sourced from the fruit of a plant. B. The area where Anisha lives receives precipitation in the form of solid state of water. C. Kavish is experiencing the season when we wear clothes made of wool. D. Fluids are of common occurrence at the place where Anisha lives. So here, it is given Anisha is making snowman with her friend in her backyard. That means Anisha is somewhere where there is winter season. Okay. And where is Kavish is beating the heat by eating ice cream. That means Kavish is somewhere where there is summer season. Got it? So we have to find out the correct statement. So here the correct statement is the area where Anisha lives receives precipitation in the form of solid states of water. So this one is correct. If it is winter and if there is snowfall and they are making snowmen, that means they receive precipitation in the form of solid state of water. Got it? So here the correct answer is option B. Coming to the next question, a note is shown in the given figure which Tarun has made about different types of houses. Unfortunately, when he had finished writing, accidentally some water spilled over the page and smudged some of the keywords. Select the correct sequence of smudged words to complete the note. Option A, nomads, tents, caravans, kucha. B, nomads, caravans, tents, igloo. C, tribesmen, caravans, tents, kucha. D, none of this. So here, what is written? Let us read here. People who roam around from place to place, they are called what? They are called nomads. Okay. They live in caves and trees. In places where it rains a lot, dense houses are made on the wooden poles. So here tilt houses are made. So these options are present in none of these options. So here the correct answer is none of this. Got it? Coming to the next question. The given figure shows a box being pushed by a boy. Identify the three forces P, Q and R acting on the box. Option A, frictional, push, gravitational. B, gravitational, frictional, push. C, frictional, gravitational, push. D, gravitational, push, frictional. Okay. So here we can see the P, force P, it is acting downward. So if it is acting downward, that means it is the which force? Gravitational force. Right? Yes. Next one is Q. You can see the boy is pushing it. Okay. The boy is pushing the box, we can say. The boy is pushing the box, we can say. Okay. So here R, that is the push. R, that is the push. And Q, you can see Q is in the opposite direction of push. So this one is the frictional force. Got it? So here the correct answer is option B, P gravitational, Q frictional, R push. Right? Coming to the next question, look at the given classification table. Which of the following can be X? Option A, blood vessels, B, brain, C, small intestine, D, backbone. So, in the given classification table, which of the following can be X? So, body system, lungs, note, they are related, okay? And heart, X. What can be X? That is the question. So, here, see, lungs and nose, they belong to the respiratory system, okay, and heart, it belongs to the circulatory system. So circulatory system, it includes heart as well as blood vessels. So here the correct answer is option A. Got it? Coming to the next question, in the given food web, a decrease in the population of bulbul is likely to cause death. Option A, increase in grasshopper and lizard population. B, decrease in plant and caterpillar population. C, decrease in grasshopper and snake population. D, increase in plant population and decrease in lizard population. So, in the given food web, a decrease in the population of bulbul is likely to cause what? Okay. So, here it is the bulbul. So, if the population of bulbul is decreasing, that means bulbul is it feeds on grasshopper. So the population of bulbul is decreasing means the population of grasshopper will increase. Okay, and about the lizard, so caterpillar, bulbul depends on caterpillar, lizard also depends on caterpillar. If the population of bulbul will decrease, then caterpillar number will be comparatively more, so then lizard number will increase. Okay, so correct answer is option A. Coming to the next question, the given diagram represents the water cycle. Select the correct option regarding the processes L, M and N. Options are A, in process M, the water vapor becomes hot to form tiny drops of water which comes together to form rain. B, in process L, water form from rivers, lakes and seas changes to water vapor due to the warmth of sunlight. C, in process N, water droplets that form clouds in the process M becomes heavy and fall back to earth as rain. Then D, both B and C. Okay, so here here we can see L. Here, what is happening here in the L? The water present in the river lake, that is the surface water, it is converted into the water vapor. And the process that is known as evaporation. Okay. So, in process L, water changes to water vapor due to the warmth of the sunlight. So, option B is correct one. Then, in process N, water droplets form that form cloud in process M. Okay, so in process M, water droplets, they condense to form means the water vapor, they condense to form cloud. So process M is the condensation. Then and in N, what is happening, they become heavy and fall back to earth as rain. So N is rain, or we can say it as precipitation. Okay, so option C is also correct. So here the correct answer is option D, both B and C. Right? Coming to the next question, select the pair of plants that has tap roots. Option A, potato, wheat. B, radish, onion. C, sugar can make the carrot reddish. So what is the correct answer? Yes, here the correct answer is option D. That is, carrot and radish, they have taproots. Got it? Coming to the next question. Which of the following will not help to control environmental pollution? Option A, traveling by bicycle instead of car. B, use of neem oil instead of insecticides to keep insects away from plants. C, burning waste material in open. D, reuse of cans, bottles and newspaper whenever possible. So we have to find out which of the following will not help to control environmental pollution. Traveling by bicycle instead of car, it will control environmental pollution. Use of neem oil instead of insecticides away from plants, it is correct, we should do that. Burning waste material in open, it will not help to control environmental pollution. It will increase the pollution. Reuse of cans, bottles and newspaper wherever possible, yes, we should go for it. So here the correct answer is option C. Okay, coming to the next question. A plant is placed in a black box with a small opening as shown in the given diagram. The setup is then placed in a sunny place and the plant is watered daily. In which direction, 1, 2, 3 or 4, will the plant grow after a few days? Options are A, 1, B, 2, C, 3, D, 4. So a plant is placed in the black box with a small opening. And the setup is placed in a sunny place and plant is watered daily. We have to find out in which direction the plant will grow after a few days. So, which direction the plant will go? Yes. So, here this one is open, right? So, the plant will grow in this direction. So, correct answer is option B, that is 2. Got it? Coming to the next question. Identify the birds P, Q and R from the given diagram and select the incorrect statement. So option A, birds of type P could be place-sitting birds like hawks and eagles. B, R type of birds could be perching birds that can hold onto a branch of a tree. C, birds of type Q can swim in water. D, in birds of type P, talons are specifically designed for running fast. Okay, so here as per the given option, option D is the correct answer. In the type of bird P, that is the three toes in front and one at the back and strong and sharp claws called talons. So here talons are specifically designed for running fast. Got it? Coming to the next question. The given diagram shows the transport of gases in our body. Which part of the body are represented by the letter W, X and Y respectively? Options are A, all body parts, heart, lungs. B, heart, all body parts, lung. C, lungs, all body parts, heart. D, all body parts, lungs, heart. Okay, so here in the given diagram, it shows the transport of gases in our body. Which part of the body are represented by the letter W, X and Y respectively? Okay, so here, so here we can see X is something from where oxygen is going, okay, and carbon dioxide is coming. So here, that is, it is the heart. X is the heart from which oxygen is going to all body parts, okay, and the body parts, they are using oxygen and they are liberating carbon dioxide. This carbon dioxide is again coming to this heart, and now from X, that is the heart, carbon dioxide is coming to Y, and Y is supplying oxygen to heart. So Y is the lungs, which is taking out carbon dioxide from the body and supplying oxygen to the heart. So here the correct answer is option A, W all body part, X heart, Y lungs. Got it? Coming to the next question, study the given flowchart and identify P, Q, R and S. options are A, Sun, Venus, Mercury, Neptune, B, Uranus, Earth, Saturn, Mars, C, Neptune, Venus, Jupiter, Mercury, D, Sun, Mars, Uranus, Venus. Okay, so here planet no, star yes, P. So here the P can be the Sun because it is a star, it is not a planet. Then planet yes, red planet yes, Q. We all know red planet, that is the Mars. So Q is the Mars here. Next planet yes, red planet no, planet with moons no. So we know the planet with that is no moons. Okay, so planet with no moons, that is here, it is Venus. Okay, then a planet with moons yes are, so it can be many, it can be many, for as per the given options it is Uranus. Got it? So yes, P Sun, Q Mars, R Uranus, S Venus. So correct answer is option D. Coming to the next question, study the given diagram which shows X, Y and Z as three states of water. Which arrows K, L, M and N represent the processes of melting and boiling? Options are A, L, M, B, K, L, C, M, N, D, N and M. So here processes are states are X, Y and Z and processes are K, L, M, N. Now we have to find out which one represents the process of melting and boiling. Both melting and boiling involves gain of heat. Okay, melting that is when solid it gains heat, it is converted to liquid, that is known as melting. And liquid, when it gains heat and starts boiling, okay, and converted to the gaseous state, this is known as boiling. So both of them involves gain of heat, and gain of heat is present in L and in M. Okay, so Z, when it is gaining heat, it is converted to Y, right? And Y, when it is gaining heat, it is converted to X. So here the correct answer is option A. L, we can write here Z, that is solid, it is gaining heat, converted to liquid. This process, that is the L, it is the melting, and liquid, it is X converted to gas, liquid is converted to gas with gaining heat. This process is known as boiling. So M is the boiling. Okay, coming to the next question, the given diagram shows transportation of food and water in a plant. Select the option that correctly identifies the parts of the plant. Then here yes, P, Q, R. Options are A, root, stem, leaf, B, stem, leaf, root, C, leaf, root, stem, D, leaf, stem, root. So the given diagram shows transportation of food and water in a plant. Select the option that correctly identifies the parts of the plant. Okay, so here the parts of the plant, this direct arrow mark, that is food, and this dotted arrow, that is water. So food from P, it is going to Q and R. Okay, we know who prepares food, leaves prepare food. Okay, so from leaves it goes to different part of plant, and it is dotted what dotted aroma, that is starting from R, which absorbs water. Yes, these are the roots. So water from the roots, they go to we can say stem. Okay, then to leaves, and food that comes from leaf to stem to root. So correct answer is option D, P leaf, Q stem and R. Got it? C, So this much for today's session. Let's meet you in the next session. Till then, read mindfully, practice all the questions properly. Okay. So meet you soon. Bye bye, everyone.